Namaste children. So our next lesson will be fractions. So at the end of the session, you will be able to explain fraction and types of fraction, represent fraction on a number line, and convert like fraction and unlike fractions, and compare the fractions. So what is a fraction? A fraction is a part of a whole. So if I order a pizza, so we all like to eat pizzas, right? And we know it is divided equally, right? So how it is shown here. So now the pizza is divided into six equal parts. If I have taken one of its part out, so how to represent this as a fraction? So a number is a fraction is a number that is used to represent a whole that has been divided into equal parts. So fraction is a what? It is a part of a whole. Now the pizza is divided into four equal parts and I have taken my part. So how many pieces are left over here? So three parts and the equal parts. So how many? The total part is four. So the three is called the numerator and here the four is called the denominator. So how many equal parts do you have? That is how many is left over here? It is three. And total pieces is the denominator. And types of fractions. So proper fraction is nothing but a proper fraction is a fraction whose numerator will be smaller than the denominator. So if the numerator is smaller than the denominator, so we can balance this, right? So for improper fraction, if the numerator is bigger than the denominator, so we can't balance, right? So this is improper. So improper fraction, if the numerator is bigger than the denominator, then it is called improper fraction. So mixed fraction will be a whole number and a fraction. It is a combination of a whole number and also a fraction. So this is called mixed fraction. Equivalent fraction. So what is an equivalent fraction? See, look at this diagram and the colored part. So all the colored part looks the same. Am I right? Yes. So, but the fractions is differs, right? So the value will be the same, but the fraction will not be the same. The fraction 1 by 2 and here 2 by 4 and 3 by 6 and here it is 4 by 8. So totally 8 parts will be there and 4 parts are colored. And here totally 6 part and 3 parts are colored. And same way here it is 4 parts and 2 parts are colored. And here it is in 2 parts and 1 part is colored. So the values are same but the fraction differs. So if the values are same then it is called equivalent fractions. How to represent fractions on a number line? So represent 3 by 7 on the number line. So first we have to take a whole number from 0 to 1. So always it should be 0 to 1, right? So 1 can be, so we are going to represent 3 by 7, right? So 1 can be represented as 7 by 7, as my denominator is what? 7. So 7 by 7. So 1 can be written as 7 by 7 and 0 can be written as 0 by 7. So instead of that, we have writing 0 as it is. So next line will be 1 by 7, 2 by 7, 3 by 7, 4 by 7, 5 by 7, 6 by 7. So we have to represent 3 by 7, right? So find where is 3 by 7 and mark it. So here it is 3 by 7. Now the next problem. So represent 1 by 4 on the number line. Same way. So my denominator here it is 4. So 1 can be represented as 4 by 4. And in between it is 1 by 4, 2 by 4 and 3 by 4. So what we have to represent? 4, 1 by 4. So color that 1 by 4. So here will be 1 by 4. So like fraction. So what is like? So if we have the same denominators, then those fractions are called like fraction. If the denominators are different, so then the fractions are unlike fractions. Comparing fractions. Now I have a dairy milk with me and I'm going to divide this to my brothers. See, my brothers are sharing their chocolates, and so the whole chocolate, first I have divided into 6 part, right? And then one of my younger brother has been given 3 parts out of this 12. So totally 12 parts will be there. So for my first brother, I have gave 6 by 12. That is 6 part out of 12. And same for my younger brother, I gave 3 part out of 12. So who got more? So the whole is the same. And the numerator, which is bigger here, so 6. So he has more, right? So 6 by 12 is greater than 3 by 12. Comparing unlike fractions. So if the denominators are same, then it is called like, and we have done here. So what happens when it is different denominators? So how to compare with different denominators? So let us learn. See, first step, first we have to see the denominators. If it is unlike, we have to make it as like. So take the LCM of the denominator. So LCM of 2 and 3 is 6. So make the denominator same. So first LCM is 6. So what to be multiplied with 6 to multiply to 2 to get 6? So it is 3. And same way, what is to be multiplied with 3 to get 6? So it is 2. So the same number should be multiplied with the numerator also. So 1 into 3 is 3. And here 1 into 2 is 2. So now compare. Now our denominators are same. Now it is like. So 3 by 6, 2 by 6. So which is greater? It is 3 by 6. That is 1 by 2 is greater than 1 by 3. So when can we compare a fractions? When they are like. So with this note, we are ending the session and we will continue in our next video. Thank you, children.